Sairam children, welcome to today's GK session. Last time we have completed till lesson number 11. Today we are going to learn lesson number 12, 13 and 14. Open your GK book children. Write today's date. Now let's learn moral lessons. Lesson number 12, learning moral lessons. Proverbs are short traditional sayings that express universal truth or moral lessons. Match column A with column B to complete this well-known proverbs. Column A. Speech is silver, as you sow. Honesty, health, work, laughter. Column B. Is the best policy, is the best medicine. Silence is gold, is wealth, is worship, so shall you reap. Column A. First, speech is silver. So what is the answer? B. Silence is gold. Speech is silver, silence is gold. As you sow. C. So shall you reap. As you sow, so shall you reap. Honesty. A. Is the best policy. Honesty is the best policy. Fourth, laughter. F. Is the best medicine. Laughter is the best medicine. Fifth, health. D. Is wealth. Health is wealth. Sixth, work is worship. Sixth goes to E. Work is worship. Yes, children, we have completed lesson number 12. Now we are going to start with lesson number 13. Now let's learn about Planet House. Write date. Lesson number 13, Planet House. Fill in the blank. The largest planet. Can you see the pic here, children? Jupiter. The largest planet, Jupiter. The smallest planet, Mercury. The smallest planet, Mercury. The hottest planet and is also called the morning or the evening star, Venus. The hottest planet and is called the morning or the evening star, Venus. The brightest planet is also Venus. The brightest planet, Venus. The planet nearest to the sun. See, children, can you see? Planet nearest to the sun, it is Mercury. The planet nearest to the sun. Mercury. The planet that is called blue planet, Neptune. The planet that is called blue planet, Neptune. Seventh. The planet that is called the red planet, that is Mars. The planet that is called the red planet, Mars. Eighth. The planet that is called the windy planet, which is that planet, Neptune. The planet that is called the windy planet, Neptune. Yes, children? We have completed. Now we will start with the 13th lesson. It is plant variety. Lesson number 14, plant variety. Fill in the blanks to see how we use these plants. The branch of this tree is used as a symbol of peace, that is olive. Can you see the olive plant here, children? The branch of this tree is used as a symbol of peace, that is olive. Second, the flower is the symbol of purity, lily. This flower is the symbol of purity, lily. Okay, you see here, children, the pig. The flower is regarded by the Chinese as the symbol of peace and beauty. That is cherry blossom. The flower is regarded by the Chinese as the symbol of peace and beauty. Cherry blossom.
Fourth, this herb is regarded as sacred by many Hindus and even worshipped. That is Tulsi. This herb is regarded as sacred by many Hindus and even worshipped. Tulsi. Fifth, the tree is sacred to both Hindus and Buddhist people. The tree is sacred to both Hindus and Buddhist people.
Now, the tree that gives fruits that are long in shape and are very sour, that is tamarind. The tree that gives fruits that are long in shape and are very sour, that is tamarind. Okay, you see children the pig. The wood of this tree has a pleasant smell and is used to make perfumes and soaps. It is also used in religious rituals, that is sandalwood. The wood of this tree has a pleasant smell and is used to make perfumes and soaps. It is also used in religious rituals, sandalwood. The wood of this tree is considered to be very good for making furniture, doors and windows. Teak. The wood of this tree is considered to be very good for making furniture, doors and windows. Teak. Ninth. The wood of this tree is used to make cricket bats. Willow. The wood of this tree is used to make cricket bats. Willow. Bye bye children. Have a great day.